Here's a bunch of updates for this video. I haven't added structural changes, but a series of minor updates that are built on top of what I have already written for the past few videos. The updates include things like back jump, some attacking and wincing variables, different states regarding crouching, and so on. Back jump is interesting because if you've been following me, you'll see that each state is made up of different components. Instead of hard coding a player state, I have a combination of different components. In other words, there really is no difference between forward jump and back jump. It's just a combination of components like moving up and moving horizontally. Forward jump involves positive horizontal numbers. Back jump involves negative horizontal numbers. Right now, the direction is the only difference, but later I'll probably have different equations because forward jump usually covers more distance than back jump. Attacking and wincing work the same way. A jab, for example, works the same way as a kick. The only difference is attack specs and hitbox specs that define things like distance, damage, timing, and so on. By editing the JSON files, either manually or through my editor, I can define how each attack behaves. If I look at a wincing state, it's also made up of components that tell you which state and animation to run when you get hit. So right now we have things like jab, kick, crouching, punch. If the target is crouched, that opens up a whole new set of different reactions and states. In combination with the hitbox editors, like you see here, and everything I said so far, I can create a bunch of different player states without worrying about the code structure. That's it for this video. If you have any questions, you can reach me with the links below. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.